In this video, I made 10,000 AI Persian warriors fight 300 AI Spartans after training them for over 30 hours. Just like in real-life battle, in the end, Persians resorted to a surprising trickery, but did it work? Make sure to watch this video till the end to find out who won in the 7th episode of Epic AI Wars. You've heard it right. I'll make 10,000 soldiers fight against only 300 soldiers. But the 300s are not your regular warriors. Oh, no, no, no.
Should have done the same.
This is blasphemy. This is madness.
Madness. This is Sparta!
Meet our new challenger, the Spartan. There have been lots of requests to add some really strong unit to the simulation, and what better candidate for this role than a Spartan? Spartans have 300 health points, making it the most tanky unit in the game so far, except of Bob, but we don't talk about Bob here. The attack speed of a Spartan is 1.5 while still dealing a full 100 damage, which means that it outperforms the warriors both in survivability and damage dealing. You can find a much more detailed description of warriors in the previous episodes, so you might want to check them out after you finish this one. But wait, there is even more! Spartans have a Bro Love buff that will restore them 25 health points per second if they have another muscular Spartan next to them in each direction, to the left, right, forward, and especially behind. Best part is all the healing stacks, so as long as you're surrounded by bros, you'll get a whooping 100 health per second. But there is even more. When a Spartan attacks with his spear, he will cast a box collider and unalive everyone inside of this box. This means Spartans can easily unalive hordes of enemies. The main thing is timing your attacks right. Which brings us to their second ability. Similar to warriors, Spartans are able to raise their shields and block any incoming attack from the forward direction. But unlike warriors, Spartans are jacked, so they don't have any stamina capacity, which means they can block as long as they want, waiting for the right moment to strike. Timing will prove extremely crucial when you have hundreds of soldiers slicing at you at the same time. Bro love and endless blocking is cool and all, but is a Spartan even a Spartan without a Spartan kick? Oh yes, they can also Spartan kick the shit out of their opponents, sending all nearby enemies flying away from them. This, by the way, proved to be a little bit of a nuisance later on in the video. By now you might think that Spartans are some invincible demigods, but let me stop you right there, since they do have a weakness, their heel of Achilles, if you will. You see, the entire strength of a Spartan formation was in how each row of soldiers was helping the row in front of them. The first row holds the enemy wave, the second row holds the first row, third row holds the second, and so on. Just like in a house of cards, where every card supports another one, every Spartan had support the others. And just like in a house of cards, that meant that once one card is removed, the entire structure falls. I wanted to enforce the same concept, and that is why the Spartans can't move nor rotate their body.
Bruh.
And that's definitely related to the story I just told you and not my inability to make them hold their lines. Yeah, not being able to move might suck a bit, but at least they have a dope cape with cloth physics, right? Right? Anyways, let me know in the comments below if you would like to see a Spartan soldier remake in a regular Epic AI Wars episode, where they can actually move and rotate and perhaps have more balanced abilities. The reason why this time I decided to melt my GPU and warm up the planet by a few degrees by having 10,000 warriors fight is not because my setup can now magically handle it. No, matter of fact, it wasn't. My unity would crash whenever I attempted to spawn 10k units, so I resorted to a small life hack, but more on that later. The reason I chose such a huge number of agents and not just any other amount is because a few weeks ago I have passed the milestone of 10,000 penguins on this channel. It's quite hard to believe it when I say it out loud, but that is actually true. I can't express how grateful I am to every single one of you. As always, I can promise that I will try to keep improving my content and make it better and better. Right now, on my Discord channel, you can get a unique role called From the Start. This role is for the OGs of this channel, so after this weekend, it will be impossible to get it anymore. So if you are an OG and been there before the 10k milestone, hurry up, link in the description. Alright, enough of the boring talks. Let's see some fighting. I have been training 50 Spartans against 150 warriors so that Spartans learn that life ain't fair from the get-go. At the beginning, nothing unusual was happening. Spartans were holding their positions, trying out different ways of unaliving their opponents, while the warriors sudoku themselves into the wall, trying to figure out what the hell they are supposed to do. About 10 rounds of bashing their heads into the wall later, and it seems the warriors finally understood that it makes more sense to fight another soldier than the wall. But the Spartans are showing no mercy. That being said, some Spartans are still getting punched in the nuts, which allows few warriors to pass by into the backlines. Unfortunately, it seems it was the bravest and not the wisest warrior who passed the Spartan defenses. So instead of attacking the Spartans from behind, after aimlessly wandering around for quite a bit, the warrior just dashed himself into the wall. That must have been a terrific experience, because next rounds more and more warriors were passing through the Spartan lines only to unalive themselves into the wall. Seeing Spartans suck ass was kinda upsetting, I'm not biased at all by the way. So I increased their health from 300 to 500, hoping it will help. Also, I've increased the amount of soldiers in each team by a factor of 2. So now we have 100 Spartans versus 300 warriors training. The main reason is that now we have 2 rows of Spartans, which in theory should allow row 1 to block enemy attacks, while backline Spartans are attacking and unaliving Persian warriors. And guess what? It actually worked! Now the front row soldiers were able to block the enemy wave, while the backlines are cleaning the ground without hesitation, being basically untouchable. Or so I thought. Remember in the beginning I mentioned some trickery by the Persians? Well, I saw how successful the Spartans became since increasing the HP and introducing the second row of soldiers, so I decided to bring their health back to 300 HP and even increase the amount of Persian warriors to 500. Despite all that, Spartans could retain their skill and held their ground against the opponents. But then... somehow the Persians have found an exploit in the physics system allowing them to climb on top of all other soldiers, including the Spartans, making them unreachable by their attacks. Most probably what happened is that whenever kicked by a Spartan, the warrior flies up and has a chance to land on top of other warriors, lol. I've tried fixing this in different ways, like removing collision between warriors so that they can't stack on top of each other. I tried increasing the height of the Spartan's collider so that warriors could not climb on top of it. But nothing really worked, so I said fuck it, it ain't a bug anymore, it's a feature now, and let the agents train for a few hundred more iterations. Finally, after about 40 hours of training, here is the final result.
Hold! Give them nothing, but take from them everything! Stay!
Hundred Spartans will be fighting against 10,000 Persian warriors. Pause this video right now and let me know in the comments below. Who do you think is gonna win? Spartans or Persians? Remember I said that I used a little trickery to be able to support 10,000 soldiers? Well, the trick is that I actually have only 500 warriors spawn at the same time, but whenever one gets unalive, it is respawned back immediately, and so until we reach 10,000. Persians have now lost almost 100 soldiers, which is mere 1% of their army size, while Spartans have already lost almost 10% of their army. Not a good start. It looks like all the work is done by the Spartans closer to the wall. All of them are actively fighting back the enemy, while in the middle we have a way more defensive gameplay. I guess that is to be expected, since most of the warriors are rushing towards the middle, and when you have hundreds of swords slashing at you every second, it might be wise to keep the shields up. That, however, doesn't explain why the back rows are not assisting. Oh, nice, looks like we finally have a new MVP that is actually fighting back. This dude has 16 kills so far. There is definitely more progress being done here. There are almost no warriors in front of these Spartans anymore. At least none that are alive. What's even more interesting is that with the fight progressing, more and more Spartans were starting to get active, and it moved in a uniform manner from the edges towards the middle soldiers. I think it might be caused by the frontline Spartans getting unalived, hence the enemies getting closer, but who knows. What I do know is that this mobilization was quite useful and at the right time, because the next few seconds, Spartans have barely lost any soldier, while reducing the number of enemies by few hundreds. Persians are now down to 9,600 soldiers, while Spartans still have 250 fighters. But then something terrible happened. Persians have remembered the trainings and resorted to their ace card, their little trickery of riding the heads of their teammates and opponents. Whether it seems that this time the strategy failed and the agent got pushed away somehow, but there are still more than 9,000 warriors that could try it once again, so let's see. Once the amount of Spartans dropped to 209, something must have happened because they went on a slaughter fest against Persians. Almost 600 Persians have fallen until just one Spartan got unalived. Now that is impressive. I think I kinda understand the strategy here now. Middle soldiers are trying to hold enemies as best as they can, which slowly forces warriors to slide and move towards the edges, where we have the fighting Spartans already awaiting them. That's a nice strategy, perhaps not the most efficient one, since, as I said, I think it would have made more sense if the middle backlines were attacking as well, but it's still quite efficient. You can see how the Spartans holding the middle get slowly dropped one by one. Persian army has suffered losses of almost 18%, while Spartans have suffered casualties of 33%. The whole thing looks pretty bad for Spartans. You can clearly see how many bodies there are near the edges, while the middle barely has any. However, judging by the warriors jumping like popcorn in the oven, I can safely assume that some of the Spartans in the backlines are actually kicking at the opponents. What followed next was a slow but consistent disintegration of the Spartan army, so I'll let you enjoy the time lapse. When half of the Spartan army was destroyed, we got the first warrior breaching the defense lines and getting behind the Spartans. It wasn't long until others followed, and that was the true beginning of the end. Damn, once again the history repeats itself, and the brave and great Spartans lose the fight against the Persians. And you could even say that it might have to do with a little trickery once again. Talking about history, huge thanks to Spartan King, Cabernaut, and Red Nugget. These guys are making history, being the first penguins to subscribe to my Patreon. Each Patreon subscriber will add to the progress bar an amount of points based on their tier. Once it reaches 100, I will be able to finally quit my job and make YouTube full-time, which means I'll be able to make more and better content. That has been a dream of mine for the past few years, so if you want to support my content and bring this dream one step closer, or simply want to get a shout-out at the end of each video, check out my Patreon page, link in the description. Meanwhile, check out my previous Epic AI Wars video, where I've tried out several of your suggestions from the comments, and some of them actually improved the soldiers. Oh, and a late happy birthday to Kalmar. Bye!